This quick tip shows you how to set up a hold function on a Mastermind controller. Buttons can have two functions, one of them that you get when you press the button quickly, and one when you hold the button for a couple seconds, and so we're going to show how this is set up. This works with any of the Mastermind series, GT, LT, PBC. We're going to be doing it on a Mastermind PBC 6 here, but the process is the same for all of them. So in the Buttons tab of the Mastermind Editor, double-click a button to get the full edit page, and then change the button mode from normal to hold. And when you do that, you'll see now there's two sections here. There's button settings, which represents the normal settings when you press the button, and now there is also hold functions, which is what happens when you hold the button for a couple seconds. So for this one, we're going to make it engage the tuner on the Mastermind PBC 6X, but this could be any function at all. It can do anything. It's, as far as the system is concerned, it's a completely independent button. So to do the tuner function, we need to set it to IA or instant access, and that's the sort of the most general purpose button that can do a lot of different things. We can name the button to tuner mute if we like, and then now we add actions, and actions are what do the actual work here. So we hit new action, and we're going to set the action type to system and the subtype to tuner. And this is what actually turns on the internal tuner on the PBC and changes the display to show tuner. What we want to also do is turn off the output. By default, it doesn't mute the output, and we want to do that in this case. So we're going to add another action, and we're going to set it to audio output number one. And so it's going to control the first output, and when the button is off, we want the output to be on. When the button is on, we want the output to be off, because, you know, normally, of course, we want output coming out of the PBC, and when we press the button, it's going to cut off the output. So that is output one. The Mastermind PBC 6 is stereo capable, so we'll add a second one to do the right side output, output number two. So now we're doing output two, and we're going to do the same thing of inverting the state so that when the button is pressed, the output is muted. The only other thing we need to do is change some of these checkboxes. We're going to take send on preset change and turn that off. The reason we want to do that is we don't want this automatically triggering every time we change presets. We can leave this on and want to leave this on, and what that'll do is even if this button is on and we change presets, it's going to turn the light off on the button so that when we return to it again, it's going to it's going to be off the way we expect it. And that's it. And so we just hit done. And the only other thing we need to do here in the global tab is we can adjust the hold time. Right now it's set to 1200 milliseconds or 1.2 seconds, and that's how long you have to hold the button before the hold function starts, and you can adjust that to whatever you like. But that's all you need to do. Go to the transfer menu and send your settings to the device, and now that button will engage the tuner when it's held, and it will turn off the tuner when you hold it again.